What is the social purpose of finance? Financiers are enablers. They enable things to happen in the real world. By channeling capital where there are real returns, problems are solved and a society can experience sustainable growth. The social purpose of finance is in allocating society's resources efficiently. At its heart, the mechanism is simple. On one side, there are all of the challenges that society faces, all of the things which a society needs to fund, all the problems that need solving. We can call them society's capital requirements. On the other side, there is all of society's money and resources, or society's capital. What's needed in the middle is a way of connecting the two, taking society's capital and allocating it to society's capital requirements in the best way that we are able to. This is the social purpose of a financial institution. Unfortunately, the existing financial infrastructure does not allocate capital efficiently, as there are positive and negative externalities, and the real returns are obscured. Many financiers are rarely aware or mindful of their social value, and often have a short-term, transactional focus. This has led to an inefficient and destructive allocation of capital, which humanity is becoming increasingly aware of. But it doesn't have to be this way. If the role of finance is to channel capital to solve society's problems, then let's talk about the biggest problem facing humanity and the broken plumbing which is preventing us addressing it. It is now widely recognized that the greatest challenge which humans are facing is the climate emergency, environmental degradation, and the breakdown of our life support systems. Throughout history, we've seen how migration, war, socioeconomic stress, and mass loss of life have all been caused by environmental pressures, insufficient resources, and food insecurity. Whatever one's political color, it is self-evident that ecosystem breakdown, pollution, climate change, and resource scarcity present fundamental threats to human life. But we can invest to solve problems, can't we? We've done this before, so why isn't it happening now? Faced with problems, efficient markets should channel capital and resources into solutions. But much market failure currently exists outside the financial system, meaning that the incentives aren't right for efficient investment. But arguably the bigger problem is that our legacy financial institutions are not delivering sufficient capital where it's needed. Even as the incentives become clear, our existing financial infrastructure is not fit for purpose to deliver this capital. In other words, the plumbing is broken. We can see the symptoms of this in the rapid emergence of disruptors across the financial sector, but there is an additional blockage. Most financiers do not believe this is important, and the institutions they work for reflect legacy belief systems that cannot deliver to solve these problems. Even now, banks can win awards for sustainable finance whilst actively working on fossil fuel transactions. The obvious answer to the problems we face is to invest more to solve them. Increasingly, investors and financiers are allocating more time and focus to do so. There has been an explosion in activity with concepts such as ESG, impact, and ethical. But while those allocations are increasing rapidly from a low base, financing continues apace in areas which, taking into account externalities, have a negative or inefficient return for society. If an investor increases an allocation to ESG, whatever that means, to say 5 or 10% of their capital, the implicit inverse is that they are allocating 90 to 95% of their capital to destroying the world. We call this the inverse pie chart. If the issues are so clear, then so is the solution. We need a new financial institution, one that understands the social purpose of finance, that addresses the biggest problem facing humanity, and keeps that inverse pie chart in mind. This is the concept of Cyan Finance, a financial institution that is 100% focused on channeling capital to deliver its social purpose and solve the problems humanity faces. Our culture and belief systems drive financial performance. So how do we do it? Much of what we do is not new. It is what financiers have been doing since they first existed. We have a relationship-based approach and develop solutions to deliver both financial and intellectual capital as the social purpose of finance has always been. We deliver financial capital directly from our own balance sheet across the capital structure. That is to say, we provide debt, equity, and everything in between. We deliver intellectual capital throughout, as well as through our advisory work. By integrating the two, we're able to channel capital where it is needed and effectively fulfill our social purpose. We do a lot of work on society's biggest challenges, but our relationship-based, mindful approach can be applied to problems large and small. We deliver financial and intellectual capital to fulfill our social purpose.